Office comes with a lot of features. One of them is a utility knife. Well, okay, it's not a literal utility knife, but templates work like a utility knife, and they do a lot of things very quickly, very well. It's in an emergency in business, if you've suddenly run out of stationery and you can't get to the printer, you can get some professional looking stationery and personalize them very quickly. You've never even thought about business cards, but you need a few for a conference you're going to tomorrow, you can find templates for that. Printed envelopes, calendars, labels, you just have some labels sitting around that you have to print out, we can get you some professional labels that you can print out. We're going to show you about how printing forms today with Office and using templates, how you can personalize it, and let's just jump right into it. There's two ways to get to templates. One is just online. You can go to office.com and click on the template tab, and you can find thousands of templates for the new version of Office, plus Office 2010, Office 2007. You can see some of the potpourri of ones that we have here, some dynamic looking ones, but again, a lot of different templates, or you can just search for them. So we're going to work with forms today. So I'm just going to type in form. Now, I probably type in something if I'm looking for something more specific, like a permission form or something like that. But this just shows you several hundred of the forms that we have for different products. You can thin your search out if you want, and you can just click on them, take a look at them. You can see how many times they've been downloaded. You can also rank templates. So you can look around, and that sometimes you might think you want a Word template, but you'll find one in Excel for your that works better for you. So you can do that at office.com. Just go to the templates tab. But you can also do it right in the product itself. So I'm going to open up Word. The latest version of Office opens up in Excel and PowerPoint and Word in this kind of template gallery. You can see the your recent documents on the left-hand side, but on the right-hand side is a gallery that, if you're online, is dynamic. We'll put up seasonal things here, like there's Valentine's Day is coming up, so you can see there's some cards and certificates. You can pin your favorite templates here to this if you want to, or again, just search for templates. If you're offline, you get just a small set of templates that can some of the more popular ones. So I'm going to search here, and I'm going to get the same results that I saw there, but these are just for Word. So I can go through here and I can browse them, and then I can look for one that I want, and we're going to choose this form here. And here's the form. Now, there's forms that are going to be just blank forms that you could print out. And then most forms are thinking about online now. So this form has what's called content controls. So you can see here where it says a patient's name. I would just fill out my name in that area and then just click on each of these controlled content to put the information right where I want it. There's also some other things going on here I want to show you that are dealing with controlled content. One up here in the date, there's actually a pull down for a calendar. You just pull in what date it is. Well, it's just today's date here. Or you can, if you're doing birthday, you could search through the calendar and put your birth date in. There's also a form up here that's called name of practice. This is actually a field that's named. We'll show you how to do this in just a moment. But if I type this in, what's interesting is this form has this name of practice at other places in the form. So if I drop to the bottom of the form, where they have this little writing, look, that information is put right in the field for me here. So those are what you can do with fields. You can have the same field repeat if you need to, where information you put in once and it populates throughout the form. So when you would get this form and you get it the way you'd set it up you wanted to, if you wanted to delete areas, you could. If you wanted to change areas, let's say I don't want this. I want to put in a new question in here. Do you like chocolate? Let's say I'm a very progressive medical place and I want to know, I want to know about chocolate. So I can, and I'm going to leave it, it says phone right now, but I'm going to change that later. I'm going to show you how I do that. So again, you get the form set up the way you want to, and then you can just save it as a template. Here I can show you that. You go to File and Save As, and save it at the desktop. And when this Save As menu pops up, The default is a Word document, but you just click on that and you can do it as a Word template. So it's the same template each time. So you've created your own template. You could title whatever you want to. Okay, but let's kind of dig in a little bit and show you how you can work with this form to get it set up the way you want to. Let's say you want to put in your own fields, like that field for chocolate. I want to put something in. What you have to do is go into the developer tab, which if you notice, your ribbon probably and my ribbon doesn't have developer in there. We need to turn it on because by default it's turned off. It's very simple to do. It works in any version of Word. You go to the file menu and click options. And you'll see lots of different options to do. But one of them is customize the ribbon. So if there's certain tabs you don't use in the ribbon or don't like or want to add some, there's some that are turned off, you can turn them on right here. So if you notice about halfway down the page there, the developer box, I just check that, press OK, and now I have a developer tab at the top of my screen. Let's click on that. Lots of scary stuff here. I mean, I'm not a developer, nor do I play one on TV. But there's a good amount of things here. When I see stuff like Visual Basic and macros, I usually run away. We're going to just go through this very lightly, just a couple things we want to do, because this way can help us with our fields here that we have formed out, this controlled content. So let me go over and click this button at the top, which is the design mode. That kind of shows you the underworkings of the document. And you can see all these fields. Some are titled, like name of practice. There's that one at the top. The date. And then other fields are put in here. So let's go down to this do you like chocolate one and work on that. I'm going to just clear out that phone one and start from scratch. So if you're starting a form from scratch, I mean, you built it. You can just start adding fields this way. You put your cursor where you want it, and then you go up here to the controls. There's several different controls. You can just put one for text, either rich text, which means you can format it, or basic text. You can add a picture if you want to. There is pull-down menus. So let's do a pull-down menu here. So I can choose an item here. And then when I've got it chosen, I just click properties. And now I'm looking at the properties for this particular tag. So the tag is called chocolate. There's other options here. I'm not going to get into all of them. But the main one down here is here's how you could add into your pull down. So you could say, do you like dark chocolate? Now I hear there's other types of chocolate out there. I don't know. I've just heard about them. I can't believe people would use milk chocolate, but I don't know. And then there's white chocolate. And there's probably others we could put in all day. And then we could press OK. And let me turn the design mode off. And now I have a choose an item, and I can choose whichever item I want. Okay. I'm going to even clear that out. And I can just do a very simple, because it's just a question, do you like chocolate? It's not really a pull-down question. So I can just put in a check mark here. And so people can check it if they like chocolate. And those are the forms I'm going to look at first, because I like people that like chocolate. So that's how you could do it. You could work with all the forms here and augment them the way you want to. You could change all that, and then you could send your document out. So we all have instructions in the blog about a little more detailed, because there's a lot of different options you can work with here. Now, one thing that happens with anything on an online form, whether you use these content controls or not, is people can monkey around with the form, right? They can delete things on purpose, like maybe they don't want to answer the question is, do you have a criminal record? You could just delete it and say, oh, I never saw that question. Or a lot of times just by accident, you're going through and you suddenly hit, you know, you have something highlighted and you hit the delete key and you don't even recognize that you've taken away some of the form. So there's a way to lock the form so it can't be monkeyed with. Let me show you that. So we're going to go again into the developer tab. And there is a button here halfway in the middle called Restrict Editing. I'm going to click that. Gives you a couple options. You can restrict just the formatting. But since I have all these nice form fields, I can edit it that it's not a read-only document. Only the filling in form area can be used. Okay, so I'm going to click on that. And then, yes, I want to start enforcing protection. Love the way that sounds. It's just going to ask me a simple password. Now, restrict editing is not like encryption and other things you can do for security. In fact, we probably should do a webinar on security. There are other beefier ways of if you have an important document. This is just to make sure people aren't accidentally deleting things. So I'm going to press OK. And now on the form, I can do things like pick a date or here's marital status. I can do that. But if you notice here, if I put my cursor here under former name or whatever, I can't even choose it to delete it. It just kind of runs up against something there. So that's protection for documents if you want to just have the form filled out. I'll go ahead and stop this. I just want to show you a quick trick that we found. Some people were asking about this, and it's what happens if you have a document. Let's say you have a picture of a document. Let me grab one here. So this is just a picture of a document that we had that we want people to fill out in a pinch, but I don't have a physical document for them. Now, I guess I could print it out or whatever, but people were wondering, how can I use this as a quick online form besides just retyping the whole form verbatim? There's a quick way. We found this on the Tech Republic blog. Susan Harkins was the one that did it, so and we'll have instructions for that, but this is how to get it into Word in a pinch if you needed to. Just kind of a little quick, a quick, clever thing. So I start with a blank document, and I'm going to insert a header. So to open up headers and footers, you can use the menu or just double-click the upper left-hand corner. That will open up your header. And now I'm going to insert that picture here. Okay, so there it is. Now, usually when you have a picture, you have text to the side, but you wrap the text around it. But actually, I'm going to work with layers. So this is actually going to go behind the text, kind of like a watermark. And let me close the header, double-click the header, and there it closes. And then it kind of grays out, if you notice that. So now that's kind of a watermark. I'm typing on top of it. And then I can work with typing here. So I'm going to just change the margins here a bit to kind of line up the form. And then maybe change the font a bit, make it a little smaller of a font. And then I'm just using like a typewriter. I'm just using my return key to move down to that last line. And it's not going to line up perfect. But if I need to have someone capture this information in this order, it can be done. Let me tab over here to the Social Security number. So I'm a little off size-wise. But you can kind of see what I'm working on. If I could work with tabs, I could work with lines and get it set up that I could do this. And I did remember on camera not to type my Social Security number, so that's good. So that's just a quick little thing that you can save this information and type it over a picture of a form. And that's, again, from the Tech Republic blog. I have instructions for that and all a little more detailed instructions about working with forms and the developer tab. You can get that at aka.ms/forms123. The homepage for the office webinar is at aka.ms/offweb, and you can get information there about the office webinar series. Next week, we have a kind of a special one. We're going to show you what Office is like on an 82-inch touchscreen. It's called Perceptive Pixel. It's what a lot of businesses are starting to use instead of just plain whiteboards. We'll show you that next week, but for today's webinar, team, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.